Hey, I saw a pizza place down the street. Maybe we could try that.
Pizza sounds delicious.
Pizza? Pizza.
Yes, pizza.
That's good.
What the heck is
that? Who puts broccoli on pizza?
That's it. I'm done.
Congratulations, San Francisco. You've ruined pizza. First the Hawaiians, and now you.
Hey, what's up, guys? Welcome back to Binging with Babish, where this week we're taking a look at the broccoli pizza from Inside Out, for which we're going to need some broccoli. But not just broccoli. I think we need something special to make this pizza movie accurate. And with the film taking place in San Francisco, I think that means a sourdough pizza made with real San Francisco sourdough starter, which you can order little desiccated packets of on the internet. Reconstitute with a little bit of water, feed with a little bit of flour, keep covered in plastic wrap and feed daily for 5 days, and just like that, you can have your own little piece of San Francisco. Or more accurately, your own little colony of San Franciscan bacteria and yeast. The things that supposedly make San Francisco sourdough so special. And now we get to use it to make pizza, adapting America's Test Kitchen's recipe for food processor pizza to accommodate a 50-50 sourdough starter. In the bowl of a food processor, we are combining 350 grams of bread flour and 2 tablespoons of sugar, processing for but a moment to combine. Then while the machine runs, we're going to add 180 grams of ice water, pausing to add our 227 grams of 50% hydration sourdough starter, then processing for about 30 seconds or until everything is evenly combined. Then we're going to let it hang out in there for 10 minutes. After which, we're going to add two of my favorite Sami Nosrat book title nouns, salt and fat, specifically a tablespoon of olive oil and a teaspoon and a half of kosher salt. Then we're going to cover and process for a full 60 seconds. This is going to cause tremendous gluten development. Then onto a lightly oiled countertop it goes, where we're going to knead it briefly to make sure that there are no dry spots or icky clumps. Then we're going to form it into a ball, plop it into an oiled container, and park it in the fridge for 12 to 24 hours. This step is optional, but it helps develop even more flavor in what's already going to be a very flavorful dough. Out the fridge it comes, and onto our countertop it goes, where we're going to divide it into two pieces, which we're going to roll between our hands using the dough's inherent stickiness to pull the top taut, forming them both into balls, which we're going to place in a generously floured proofing container and proof at room temperature for 2 hours before shaping and baking. Plenty of time to do some stuff. First, preheating a pizza stone or pizza steel on the top rack in an oven set to 500 degrees Fahrenheit for 1 hour. Second, we're going to divide and conquer some florets of broccoli, also thinly slicing some of the stem, which is visible on the pizza in the movie. All these broccoli bits are headed into a steamer basket for about 4 minutes or until tender crisp, one of my very favorite adjectives. These guys are then headed directly into an ice water bath. This is both going to halt their cooking and help them maintain their poppin' color. Dab them dry, and with that, we are ready to assemble a pizza that's borderline, barely, just ever so slightly healthy. For you. We're going to start by generously dusting both our worktop and both sides of our dough ball with flour. This dough can be a little sticky, and it is virtually impossible to use too much flour at this stage. Then, rounder, prettier side up, and starting from the center, we're going to pat the dough out to about a 6-inch round, lift it up, and pass it knuckle over knuckle, slowly stretching it out to about a 14-inch round, ever so slightly thicker on the outside rim, and as thin as possible in the center. Then we are generously dusting our pizza peel with flour before transferring the dough over, making any final adjustments to roundness, or mostly just roundness. And then this looked like a white pizza, so I'm going to brush it down with about a tablespoon of olive oil that I've mixed together with 1 crushed clove of garlic before blanketing generously with shredded, full-fat, low-moisture mozzarella cheese. And we're topping that with our steamed broccoli that I'm going to bust into bite-sized bits. Then we're sliding that onto our preheated pizza stone and or steel for anywhere from 12 to 15 minutes, rotating as necessary to get nice, even browning. Retrieve your pie, let it cool for 2 to 3 minutes before slicing and serving to the absolute horror of anyone under the age of 12. But I like broccoli, and I like garlic, and I like cheese, and this has all three, and a nicely browned underbelly. So let's make sure to serve it up on paper plates, just like in the movie, and give it a shot. And first off, I definitely under-cheesed it, if you couldn't tell from the lack of cheese stretch. And it's perfectly good, if not a little simple. But is it movie accurate? For more insight, I think we need to turn to kitchen producer Kendall Beach, someone who's actually visited San Francisco's Arizmendi, the inspiration for the pizza in the film. So Kendall, what do you think?
I think this is fantastic. The sourdough crust, delicious. But as you often say, I think we can do better.
So with that in mind, let's start with the garlic. We're going to make garlic confit. Basically, we're just putting a bunch of garlic cloves in a small saucepan, covering with olive oil, adding a pinch of kosher salt, a few twists of freshly ground black pepper, and a couple dry, spicy chilies, bringing the whole thing to a bare simmer over the lowest possible heat. Also, I forgot to mention a bay leaf. We're cooking that for about half an hour or until the garlic is completely soft, making sure it's completely cooled before tasting one of the tender, sweet cloves. Next up, something I've personally never tried on a pizza, but I think is going to work wonders, a bechamel. well. Into a saucepan goes 2 tablespoons of butter melted, followed by 2 tablespoons of flour that we're going to whisk and cook until lumpless and the raw flour smell has abated. Then, a little splash at a time, we're going to add 1 cup of cold milk, making sure that the mixture is completely smoothed before each additional splash. This will ensure a nice, smooth bechamel. Once all the milk's added, we're going to cook it for about 5 minutes and season it with white pepper, freshly grated nutmeg, and kosher salt to taste. Next up, the broccoli. We got a lot of really rich stuff happening on this pizza, so I think some broccoli rabe is going to play real nice. We're cutting off the stems and most of the leaves and cutting everything into bite-sized pieces and then sauteing briefly in some olive oil over medium-high heat. And then, ironically, something that helps offset the bitterness of broccoli rabe is a little squeeze of lemon juice. Let it be known that science doesn't always make sense. Then it's the same procedure with the pizza dough. Just pat it down, knuckle it out, achieving thinness and roundness. Then this time we're going to brush it down with the oil from the garlic confit and crush the garlic over top. Then next up is the bechamel, which in retrospect you might want to do first. It's kind of tricky to spread on an oily surface. Then atop that, we're going to arrange the broccoli rabe in a pleasing pattern. And then, especially if you're a YouTuber and you need a stretchy thumbnail, we're not going to skimp on the cheese, adding some freshly grated Parmesan for flavor bonus points. One last chance to shape, and then it's headed in the oven, same deal, 12 to 15 minutes rotating for even browning. And right away you can tell, bechamel on pizza is a really, really good idea. Not only for its lovely dappled brownness, but it makes everything gooier and cheesier like in a lasagna. But how's it taste? Well, folks, I'm happy to report that we're starting 2021 off right with what's gotta be one of the best pizzas I've ever made. It's super flavorful and cheesy and rich, and ow, that's hot. And the sourdough makes the crust actually worth eating. But let's call in our resident expert on San Francisco style pizza. Kendall, what do you think?
This is fantastic. So much better than the first one. And the first one was pretty dang great. It's all amazing. And honestly, I think this is the best and the closest you're going to get to Arizmendi here on the East Coast.
Wow. High praise indeed. Well, I'm just glad I could make Papa Pixar proud. Now excuse me while I eat all of this.